How's retirement?
Retirement, it's been good.
I mean, was that something you just said after the fight, you just were frustrated, or was that something you were really thinking about or something that was a possibility?
Well, at the time, I really meant it.
Yeah.
But whenever I got home, talked to my wife, she was like, you know, in certain words that I can't even say at all, that I won't even say on the mic especially, she said, you ain't retiring.
Sometimes that happens. Sometimes we have to do what we're told. I know you've talked about it a lot, but you know, you went through with Houston, with your hometown, everything you went through. I guess did you feel a sense of responsibility to the community, or is that just something that's just you, and that's how you handle things when there's adversity, you kind of go after it?
You know, I'm comfortable in my life right now, and so if I'm in a position to help anyone that I can, I will. If it's my last dime, I still will help them. I don't care. That's just, I always been that type of person. Yeah, Houston right now is everyone furniture and carpet and stuff like that. Sheetrock is probably like 10 feet high in the front yard right now. And it seems like it ain't going nowhere. You know, it's still like that till this day. In certain areas, it's still flood waters, and roads are closed still. I believe I did, I guess you say, enough from what I could do, but I believe the first responders are doing an excellent job right now.
You went through that, and now you're here in Vegas, which is going through its own, you know, awful situation. So what has it kind of been like for you to be here and, you know, see what's going on in this city?
Yeah, hearing all of that happening here in Vegas, it was like heartbreaking, you know, like it drained me literally hearing that, because it's like all these tragedies happen back to back. You know, especially around the same time whenever the country was really trying to divide each other about the Confederate flag and the statues and all that, then all these tragedies happened back to back like this. And I just believe that God just really trying to sit everybody down and show everyone that we need each other no matter what.
So, I mean, do you hope that positive comes out of all this? I mean, obviously everybody hopes, but do you think positives can come out of all these bad things that are happening?
I believe so, you know, because we was heading to a dark place, you know, we really was. I'm an emotional guy, you know, I do everything off of my emotions, you know, especially in fighting. You know, I'm going out there trying to fight a guy that ain't did nothing to me, didn't say nothing bad about me. It was one of the bad things fighting Mark Hunt. The guy didn't say, he was a nice guy, you know, I just wanted to fight him. So it was just going to be real hard, but I believe I'll get through it.
Is that part of what weighed into, you know, you kind of getting frustrated and not want to do it anymore? Like, I don't
want
to keep fighting these people, and they didn't do anything to me?
Yeah, you got to be a special person to get inside of the octagon and fight somebody and then do anything until you try to hurt them. I guess some type of motivation, like trying to be a millionaire, I guess.
That's a little
motivation, huh? They believe I'm like two fights away from fighting for the title. You know, I just want to get paid. It don't matter. I don't care if I ever fight for the title. I believe this fight right here is me fighting for the title, because he was a champion a year ago. And the only reason why he lost because from a fluke punch, you know.